It's funny how we pour all of our energy into client work, refining every detail, hitting every deadline, but when it's time to work on our own portfolios, total blank. Where do you even start? In this video, we'll show you some of the best portfolio websites created on Tilda and talk about why they work. So if you're feeling stuck, this might just be the push you need to finally launch your portfolio website.
Stick until the end for a bonus to kickstart your portfolio on Tilda for free.
All right, so this is the first portfolio from a creative art director. And it opens with this bold showreel that grabs your attention right away and lets the work do the talking. And if you're a visual creator, consider introducing your work early on the page to let it speak for itself.
Next, below the showreel, there is a short and sweet intro. It's very factual with a clear call to action to prompt the user to take the next step. And moving on, before the main showcase, there is a quick motto. It gives the user a moment to pause before diving into the visuals. It's a nice touch of rhythm you might want to copy on your own website.
Now onto the work.
And what I love here is how each project doesn't just show the final product, but also breaks down exactly what the art director did and what results it helped clients achieve. The context behind your work is key. Like, for example, this is not just a holiday ad video. You can see that it gained over 200 million views, 80% organic reach, helping to spread brand awareness.
Metrics like that speak volumes.
And we tend to notice numbers and keywords more often than just plain descriptions or visuals without any text. And the whole website keeps a really good flow, mixing dynamic elements like video with simple photo grids. It creates a nice visual rhythm and keeps you engaged. Then comes the social proof, awards, client logos, all shown in a clean, subtle way that builds trust. Next, an about section. And what I like about it, it's not self-indulgent. Even when it's personal, it still keeps the spotlight on the work. Then we have the process section. It answers all questions before they even asked, which helps build confidence with potential clients as they clearly see what to expect. And finally, contact info, straight to the point with a call to action that nudges visitors to take the next step.
So this website is an amazing example of how you can let the work speak first, backing it up with real results and making it super easy for visitors to connect. All right, let's move on to the next website. And here we have this vibrant portfolio built for a content creator duo specializing in food and beverage. And what I love right away is how clear and direct the hero section is. Here we have the bold headline, photographer and stylist duo that specialize in creating content. It immediately tells you what they do. And just below, there is a short about section that gives you quick context without taking up too much space. And if you want to explore more about the creators, you can always click see more to access a dedicated page. And because this is a dual portfolio, we get to see info about both creators. And I really like how they use unique fonts and subtle animations. It adds a nice personal touch to the website. And content-wise, it also strikes a nice balance. Here we have fun personal trivia like favorite colors and food, alongside solid social proof like years of experience, education, and even a few big name clients. And that kind of credibility is especially important for freelance creatives who need to showcase that they know their stuff. And just like in the previous example, using clear keywords and numbers is a smart move. So it always helps you grab attention, help potential clients quickly get what you're about. Next up is the services section. It breaks down the types of content they offer, and each category includes a sample image that appears on Hover, a very smart use of micro-interactions. And if you're curious, you can easily click through to the full page for more details. And here we can see an in-depth look at each service they're offering, covering any immediate questions the users may have. And it's great that it doesn't clutter the homepage by providing a snippet and more detailed description on a separate page. And the portfolio section follows the same logic, right? So the slider gives you a quick taste of the work, and if something catches your eye, you can always go and dive deeper into each project by clicking see more. And it's a simple layout that lets the work speak for itself. And if you already provided enough context on the process and the services that you provide elsewhere, this kind of portfolio is a great way to just showcase your work and let potential clients scroll through it at their own pace. Back to the homepage, then we have a lead gen form inviting users to subscribe to the newsletter. And it's a great reminder that not every visitor is ready to hire just yet. But staying in touch through a monthly newsletter can keep you top of mind. And finally, in the footer, we have a live Instagram feed. It's a great way to keep the website feeling fresh and show a bit of behind the scenes without needing constant updates, because the block will fetch your Instagram feed and share the pictures on your website. So this portfolio website is a great example of how to organize your content effectively to showcase a wide range of your work without making your layout feel cluttered. And this portfolio really shows that you don't have to choose between being authentic or polished. And with the right approach, you can always present your work in a way that's both engaging and credible. Maybe you're looking for something more minimalist. So next up, we have this personal and fashion stylist website. And it's really a great example of how you can use clean, simple layout to help showcase your work in a very eloquent and elegant way. And right from the homepage, the visitors can choose what interests them most. So personal styling or fashion styling. And this approach works really well if you offer a different range of services or if you cater to different clients. And by separating the offerings, you can always tailor the experience and messaging for each audience. All right, so let's enter the personal styling section. And here we met with a minimalist and elegant layout, and it starts with some visuals followed by short points that introduce the stylist and her values. And it's very subtle, but highly personal.
And if your work is about helping others with their unique needs, consider including a Why Me section. This is your chance to speak directly to potential clients and build trust for clarity and empathy. Next up, we have the services section. It's really concise and practical, listing offerings with pricing to address basic client inquiries and guide them towards the next step with a clear call to action. And just below, there is an FAQ section that answers common questions, reducing friction for those who are ready to book.
So next, let's switch to the fashion styling section from the homepage. And this layout becomes more classic portfolio style, ideal for showcasing finished looks.
And unlike personal styling, fashion clients often want to see polished results, and I think this portfolio section really provides just that. Next up, we have this dynamic checkerboard layout that alternates between text and images, which adds contrast and creates a visually engaging flow that grabs users' attention.
So if your brand tends to lean towards more minimalist style, I think it's a really great example to fall back on and, you know, implement this clean, simplistic layout on your own website. And you can achieve it with the right typography and images and just combine them together in a way that will help you achieve this simple look without overcomplicating things. Maybe you want something that will set you apart with a personal touch. Then you gotta check this website. It has this super charming handmade feel. It almost feels like a creative scrapbook.
The handwritten font, the playful little illustrations, it all just works so well together.
Now, I know you might be thinking, creative websites often look good, but oftentimes they tend to be chaotic and really hard to use because they focus more on the looks rather than functionality. Well, not this one.
It's actually really well organized and easy to navigate. And on top of that, it's functional too. It's not just a portfolio, but also has a built-in print shop. So it doesn't just look cool, it works to attract both clients and customers. And one of my favorite parts is the portfolio section. It's set up chronologically, first by year, then by season, so you can scroll through and literally see how the work evolved over time. If you've got a big archive of projects, this kind of layout could be a great way to keep things tidy while still showing off your journey. So if a brand has a more informal and playful tone, consider swapping conventional UI elements for illustrations, animations, or handwritten text. For example, instead of a typical How It Works section, this website uses illustrated cameras to showcase the photographer's gear paired with casual notes about tools and shooting locations, which makes the whole experience feel more personal and engaging.
Sometimes you want something simple, but still functional and creative. And this website is a great example of how you can showcase your work in a subtle yet refined way. As you scroll, you're met with a clear, straightforward title followed by a curated list of projects. And each one includes a preview image on hover and a few keywords and tags, just enough to give recruiters or clients a quick sense of the designer's style and capabilities. And below that, there is this short bio and contact info.
It's minimal, but everything you need is right there. And the layout provides all the necessary content in one place while still feeling stylish and intentional. What I especially love here is the way you can dive deeper into each individual project. Just click and you're taken to a dedicated case study page. Like in this example, the designer walks you through the process for a branding project, step by step, without cluttering the homepage. It's a really great way to balance simplicity and depth, keeping the homepage clean while still offering room for storytelling.
All right, I hope you enjoyed this selection of portfolio websites. and you've picked up some fresh ideas for your own website. To help you get serious about building your portfolio, we're giving you 3 months of the Tilde Personal Plan. Check out the description to claim your own free plan, and don't forget to share your results with us. We'd love to see what you create.